Hey, it's Monday, and today we're here to talk about LECA and your plants and what could be wrong. Why is there fur growing down the side of your pot? Stay tuned. So I'm sorry to disappoint y'all. I was supposed to do a houseplant and house tour today. However, the painters took a lot longer than we thought they would take, and it's just taking me time to get my house back, put back together. However, it's gonna be a good one, so stay tuned. Today, we're gonna talk about fur growing in your pots. Now, this hasn't happened to me in a while, and I'm going to give my opinion as to why I think mold, mildew, spores start kind of taking over in the LECA. It's basically like moldy bread, but it's moldy LECA. And what I'll do is go ahead and transfer a plant at the same time. This is one of my new plants. This is a Japanese Aralia. Japanese Aralia. Look at the cute little, oh, there's a little baby. I don't know if you can see the little baby. These are outdoor plants, the Aralias, however you can grow them indoors. I did find some of these on plantarina.com. So if you like this and you want one, go to plantarina.com. They're not super expensive. This is a kind of newish hybrid from 2 or 3 years ago. It's called the Camouflage. And I am a sucker for any plant tropical. It doesn't actually have to be tropical, but to me, this looked really tropical and I loved it. Now, I did get a warning from someone on Instagram. They said they tried to put theirs in LECA and it died. So I got two, of course, one for insurance and one for LECA. Just so y'all know, if you see ink on my fingers, a smashed thumb, a black eye, I am extremely clumsy. And so when I did taxes this morning, I had gotten some ink in my office area and it had spilled back behind where I keep all of my tax paperwork. So it's something like that every single day of my life. You're just happening to see today's thing on camera. The main thing is when I first repot something, I like to get all of the dirt off, but I want it to be really dry. A very fine, delicate, hairy root system. Do not use LECA. That's the first thing. What I'm gonna use on this one, I mean, you can use LECA, but the LECA balls with the fine delicates, it's very difficult to get a nice balance with your watering. Okay, so, and the dirt came out pretty well. There we go. Okay, so this is why I think your plants are molding and mildewing and getting furry, kind of fungusy mold. When I plant this plant, see how it's long on the roots? It used to be, I would try to, because I had a pot that I wanted to use. Let's say I want to use this pot, I would try to graduate these roots. So here's the bottom of the roots, and I would try to graduate them up the LECA. And I got some furry mold and mildew issues with that. And I think it's because it's too much water and too much LECA, and like, it's too much. Once I started going like this, look how tiny that is. But taking all of the roots, and I can even cut these roots off and start over, but my pot on this is going to be quite small. I can either do a small pot, or I can do a little bit bigger pot, but plant it down, really down in. And then once it's adapted, I kind of pull it up and put a little more substrate underneath, and then I just move it up as the roots grow down. That's the trick. If you have tried to graduate these roots and leak them down into the LECA, it doesn't work. This root system has to adapt to the whole water culture thing. And if you're relying on these tiny little roots to drink up all the water in the bottom of this, it overwhelms the plant. The plant can't do it. Then there's just water hanging out, hanging out, hanging out. And you'll start seeing mold and mildew growing. If you can really compact, and this is me, I know this is probably different from every person that does LECA, but what I found is if you can really make those roots be kind of tight and low in the pot, you're gonna put your LECA, I'm not gonna use LECA, substrate down here and put the roots right directly on top of the first half inch to an inch at the most. On this one, I'm gonna do a half inch of substrate. Fill the rest with the rest of the substrate, and then the first couple of waterings, pure water only. I'm just gonna let the water run through. I'm not gonna let any water sit on the bottom of this for the first month. And then every Monday on this is my newest plan, on Mondays, my newly converted plants, my new plants that just went to LECA, I run the water through them and then make sure there's no water in the bottom. After I see some stabilization, some leaves that are not yellow, they're happier and perkier, then, the next Monday, I may leave a little bit in the bottom. But that's where I have seen mold and mildew. If I tried to plant this in here, it would be awful, full of mold and mildew. And part of it is because this is alive. It's an alive substance, and you're gonna have roots that are definitely gonna rot. And so those rotting roots plus too much water is going to encourage mold and mildew to grow. The other thing, I don't have, and I don't do, are humidifiers. Now, if you live in a dry area and you're trying to do an indoor jungle, you kind of have to, do humidifiers. I don't really do humidifiers because humidifiers will pass spores through the air, and you can spread disease to all of your plants more easily because of humidifiers. So I do try to give my plants humidity creatively. I will put them in the shower with me and let the steam work, if because I want just natural humidity from a running bath, a running shower, by the kitchen sink. I'd rather have that than have humidifiers passing possible spores to all of the plants. Okay, so I'm actually not gonna put this plant in LECA. And that is the beauty of what we're doing here. We're actually taking plants out of their environment of dirt, which a lot of people are like, oh, that's their natural environment, but it's actually not. A lot of houseplants grow in tropical areas, up trees and on the sides of the roots of other plants and that kind of thing. So they actually will feel set free when they are freed from dirt. But we have to convince them that they want to be free from dirt. And that is what this show is really about. Now, this is the pot of the dirt that the plant came in. And this is the pot I'm going to transfer it into. So there is a big difference between this pot and this pot, but I am determined not to have the mold and mildew growing throughout the LECA. I did cut the roots off so that they're nice and squatty, and then I sprayed it with hydrogen peroxide first. I like to use hydrogen peroxide as a preventative for root rot, mold, mildew, snails, any little gifts that come from the nursery, they tend to be taken care of with just plain Jane hydrogen peroxide from your local pharmacy. I just do it one time. If I have, some issues down the road, sometimes I will actually water with hydrogen peroxide, let it bubble, fizz, flush, and then do a normal watering if I feel like I need to kill something that's inside the pot and I don't want to. It's the Mother Earth Premium Pumice. Vulcanite is the brand. If y'all find a better brand or another source, let me know. I found it on Amazon. The link is down below. It is $30-something on Amazon, and it's worth your while and worth your time if you Google a local hydroponic supply store and find one. My hydroponic supply store, it's $17. So I have ordered Amazon when I've gotten desperate, and my hydroponic supply store runs out pretty often. The last time I went, I got 5 bags because I love vulcanite. Love, love, love it. And now, usually I mix that volcanic pumice with LECA, but in this case, with these little fine baby hair roots, and I'm gonna try this also on some more plants. There's plants that seem to have a rough time in LECA. A lot of your like string of pearls and all of those baby fine roots, that is my next quest in LECA or substrate, is to find the very best solution for those plants, because they don't, the LECA is a bigger ball and it seems to keep those roots too wet for too long. So what I did this time is I mixed my volcanic pumice and perlite together. Now perlite is also a volcanic substance, but it is very light, very airy, and will not hold moisture. So it's a better, to me, it's a better thing to put in there than styrofoam. And the only problem with perlite that I have is you see how kind of big this plant is and how small the roots are. You really want weight. You want to be able for the plant to be firm. So we're gonna see when we plant today how firm it is. If it topples a little bit, what I will do is I will do my pumice and my perlite mix in the whole thing, and then on the very top just dump a bunch of volcanic pumice because the pumice is heavy. The other thing is I'm using just a plain Jane little, you can even use, you know, a plastic cup, but I took a nail and I put it on under fire and I poked holes in this one. I really want a lot of aeration in this. I want it to be arid and light. I don't want these roots to ever feel like they're drowning or suffocating. So I did poke a bunch of holes in this. Is put 1/2 inch of my mix in there, and then I'm going to place these roots right firmly on top of that 1/2 inch. Can I link them below? I'm gonna link a small one below too, because this is my big one for my big pots. I really love this silicone OXO thing because you can squeeze it and you don't get your stuff everywhere, all over your house. Okay, so I'm just gonna pour it in. Literally, it's gonna take me 2 seconds to plant this once I have cleaned off the roots and done spraying of the roots. To plant it is so fast. And then when you want to move it to a bigger pot or make a change, just fooling with the plant once it's out of dirt is so fast and easy. Okay, so it is in. Just take like a paintbrush, and what I like to do is poke your paintbrush kind of, we're gonna poke it down in there because we want all of those roots to be completely surrounded, immersed, whatever the word is, in this aggregate. We don't want any roots to be, no root left behind. Now, to stabilize this plant a little bit, I'm gonna do just the heavy volcanic pumice on the top because I really want this to be stabilized. Now, what's so cool about taking your plants out of the dirt and putting them into LECA or another aggregate is you're not going to have, you may have fruit flies, you will not have them like you have them in dirt. Fruit flies lay their eggs in dirt, so it really does help with a lot of the pests. The reason I gave up houseplants 10 years ago was pest, and the reason I took it up again 3 or 4 years ago was LECA. So if you are very opposed to pest but you really want houseplants, this might be a good thing for you to do. Okay, so it's in there. And this is my cash pot. And there we have it. It's just gorgeous. I love it. It's just been planted and it will not get mold or mildew because it's very low in the pot. And the roots were a tiny bit damp. I like to leave it for a couple of days in kind of dry lecca or dry, you know, aggregate. And then after a couple of days, I'll just run water through it to give it a nice watering and then put it back in the pot with no water in the bottom. And I'll do that for 3 or 4 weeks. And then you'll start to see signs of growth and you can, you know, okay, the roots have taken root. If you're nervous about a plant, you can pull it out, pull off any rotten roots, spray it with hydrogen peroxide, let it dry out, put it in fresh lecca or fresh substrate again, and then start again. But don't be horrified if you see mold and mildew or some kind of furry stuff growing. It's not something to be afraid of. It's actually quite normal when you're first starting out your journey in lecca because you're guessing, you're looking at Instagrams and you're looking at other things and you're like, well, I guess this is where I want it in the pot. But I promise you, if you put it lower in your pot, you're gonna have less mold, mildew issues and fungus issues. Add H2O2 into your system. The question of the day is, have you had mold and mildew issues with your plants? What did you do to correct it? So can't wait to see y'all next time. Thank you so much for liking, subscribing, coming. Love y'all. Bye-bye.